Looks like the Excalibians are ready to resume the trials. As you know, our participation is required, whether we like it or not. Under the circumstances, keeping them waiting isn't wise.
Until next time.
Seen many things in the trials. Your actions have given us much to consider, but we require more data. You can remove yourself from the trials if you so desire. I believe you are aware of the consequences such an action will bring. Then, if you wish to proceed, the portal awaits.
The next trial lies this way.
This is incredible. The architecture, the technology, the art. It's not like anything I've ever seen before. Where are we?
The Excalibians have dropped us into another planetary assault by the look of things. There's a battle site ahead. We might be able to learn more about our surroundings by examining it.
According to my tricorder, these soldiers are from extinct species. The Dinosians and the Ichabar.
Several extinct species, Iconian tech. I think this battle is the fall of Iconia. If so, we might be able to stop the chain of events that eventually lead to the Iconian War in our time. Considering the previous trials, I can see that as the pivotal event we were sent here to encounter. Have heavy gunfire nearby. Keep your weapons handy.
More fighting ahead.
Wait. Are those Iconians?
Of Iconia. You are not known to us. Halt and identify yourself. I do not recognize your species, but you have taken up arms to defend Iconia. That makes you an ally, and your assistance is appreciated. You have my thanks.
I am called Lemiren. My thanks to you as well, newcomers. Our situation is quite dire. M'Tara, our leader, has fallen. Iconia will soon be lost to our enemies. We must withdraw. We were trying to reach a nearby gateway when those soldiers attacked. Their reinforcements could arrive at any moment. Will you help us once again?
Orbital attack! The warfare of cowards!
Hold. Reading an energy spike in the gateway. Something's active.
No, there will be no more. We will fight. Slay any foe who dares to cross our path.
It's more under the bridge than the rumors we see.
Henry V.
To ruin by the barbaric dregs of the galaxy. This time, I shall not fail. Lemurin, give me the world heart. Give me the means to rid the cosmos of our enemies. To return Ikoria to greatness once more.
I hear the bloodlust in your voice. I see the hatred burning in your eyes. But you do not frighten me. The world heart is ours. We will use it to rebuild what has been lost. Be gone from here, demon. You will not prevail on this day.
That energy is protecting the temple. I have no way to stop that.
You fought a war with the Iconians and survived?
The gateway is ready. Use the console in front to shut it down.
Signal you when I'm ready once more.
defeated for the likes of you. My life is not yours to take, Vermin.
Nightmare, utterly corrupted by hatred and a thirst for vengeance. But what did she become? I have seen terrible things on this day. The fall of my civilization, of my beloved friends, of the totality of Iconian knowledge and culture. I cannot abide these tragedies. I cannot. Please, you can follow that monster. You can go where I cannot. I beseech you, return the world heart to me. Do not let Iconia fall to darkness.
Something is amiss, my friends. The trial has taken a life of its own, expanding well beyond its original parameters. Though I implored Yarnik and his ilk to bring the trial to an end, they have refused. They wish to see how you address this new crisis. Tread lightly. There is an ill wind blowing upon this venture. I fear one that may consume us all before the end.
These Borg, are they an evolution of control? Did someone else try to recreate it later on? Seven, what we saw on Esau 4, your detailed knowledge of the Borg, you used to be one of them, didn't you?
Yeah. I was assimilated by the Borg at a young age and liberated by the crew of the USS Voyager later in life. The assimilation process is reversible, mostly, but it leaves scars, inside and out.
I'm sorry that happened to you. And I'm sorry to ask this now. Are we going to have a problem here? With you and the Borg? Under the circumstances, I can see how you could become emotionally compromised.
This isn't the first time I've run into Borg since my liberation, and I doubt it'll be the last. I'll be fine, Commander. If it makes you feel any better, if I go native here, you have permission to shoot me.
Fair enough. Thanks. Any advice on fighting the Borg?
Right. Combat with the Borg is likely. We need frequency remodulators. Tell me when you want to proceed, and I can open the force field ahead at that time. Borg can adapt their shielding and render weapons ineffective. A frequency remodulator can adjust your weapons to bypass their adaptations and force them to readapt. Not a perfect solution, but it beats having a useless weapon against them. Don't forget to equip a frequency remodulator. 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 Don't forget to equip a frequency remodulator.
as you know it, is over.
I don't like where this is heading. The Borg, they're relentless.
Time's a factor here. The longer the Borg have to build their forces and strengthen their position, the harder it'll be to undo their plans.
7 and 9. The conical throne returns. At first, my existence seemed flawed, incomplete. I sought answers, and within the Untrials, I found them. I was a simulacrum, brought to me by this howling consumed to test you.
Resistance is free. my pass from time to time, but it usually doesn't shoot back. I'll manage. We need to deal with my evil twin and the Queen, however. The thought of them both running free makes me very uncomfortable.
Up a lot of energy spikes in the next room. It could be weapons fire.
It's the personal chamber of the Borg Queen. Maybe the Excalibur sent some allies to help out. If so, they might need our help. Want me to lower the field? That's the Borg Queen. Indeed. It's damn peculiar. If the Excalibians killed her, where are they now? Be careful. Whatever did this could still be around, and it might not be friendly.
Not sure if this is better or worse than what controlled that plan.
Pretty sure it's worse. I'm biased.
Passionate you are. So frightened of perfection.
Last time I checked, we're not the ones hiding in the dark.
That's a good point.
Here's another. You are obsolete. Older. Weaker. Inferior to me in every way.
Inferior to you? You're a pathetic copy of me hiding behind a legion of drones. You're weak.
Tell me, why are you calling? There will be no struggle. No resistance.
You're a smart girl. You'll figure it out eventually.
How predictable. How human. We know where that happens. Futility.
And a new nightmare begins.
Automated defenses coming online.
My name's Pahvo. I am Borg. I am eternal. My victory is in me.
How is she still functioning?
There's so much more to me than possibly imagine.
Ass just got kicked again.
You are done here at last, my friends. I'm glad you're still with us, my friends. I'll ask you to come with me. Yarnik wishes to speak with you, and time is short.
The assimilation of this planet and everything on it. We must consider our alternatives while there is still time.
We should take care of that Borg ship while we can.
Apparently not. President Lincoln has asked me to assist him in something. If I don't see either of you again, it has been an honor.
The Borg Queen is assimilating the Excalibians one by one. If she's not stopped, it's only a matter of time before she learns to use their matter-shaping powers. Difficult to say. She will learn to replicate well-known patterns first, like Borg ships. It could take her much longer to learn to make entirely new things, or to create things from imagination and memory.
Thank you.
pray to die a pointless death.
Your arrogance is impressive. Annoying, but impressive.
Arrogance? Is it arrogance you hear, or a statement of inevitable fact? Perhaps now your opinion has changed. Perhaps now you realize the futility of resistance.
Looks like you could use a hand here.
I hope you don't mind, but I brought some friends.
This is Captain Jonathan Archer of the Starship Enterprise.
Colonel Dan, on that battle station.
Let's make sure history never forgets the name Enterprise. As an old saying, fortune favors the bold. Well, I guess we're about to find out.
I think it's time to do a little assimilating of our own.
Hmm?
Still think resistance is futile? Your Majesty?
Resistance? You're a tragic collection of relics and fools. The first of many to die.
Load to beta base. Arm phasers. Lock coordinates on the source of the tractor beam.
Fire.
let the forces of evil destroy us, even though we have placed them in mortal peril. You have given us much to consider and to understand. You have shown us that it is not good to subject others to dangers that we are not willing to face ourselves. Let us meet face to face one last time and resolve these matters.
Certainly been a learning experience for me as well as the Excalibians. I saw what I was and what I could have been, which makes me grateful for the life I have now. Still, this experience should make the next session with my counselor interesting. In the meantime, that sensor grid in the Traelus system will need some final adjustments. Can get me back to my runabout, I can finish those. I can also speak to some Fenris Rangers about looking into the Orion smuggling activity in Traelus. Unofficially, of course.
Sounds like Yarnek and his people have a lot to think about. I hope they mean it when they say they're going to pursue goodness. As for me, it's strange, being... what did the Borg Queen call it? A simulacrum? A copy. And an incomplete one at that. I'm based on a Starfleet science officer. I was going to figure it out sooner or later. Now that I know, I've decided to continue what was started here today. In my own way. I've asked the Excalibians to make my transformation permanent. And they've agreed. So, for the Excalibians, the trials are over. But for me, the human adventure is just beginning. If you don't mind, I could use a ride to the nearest Alliance starbase. I'd like to speak with Starfleet Command about reactivating my commission. Among other things.
It's been quite some time since I had to go into combat. It was an honor to fight by your side. The Excalibians have asked me to remain as I am now, and to serve as an ambassador for this planet. These people have a great deal to learn about the universe, and I believe the Alliance can help them with that. And, having some experience as a statesman, I might be able to make that process a little smoother for all parties involved. Should you return here, you will be most welcome. You've done all of us on Excalibur a great service today. One we will never forget. And for that, I thank you. Until we meet again, my friend, farewell.
The Advocates of God return. We have learned much from your efforts in the trials. We did. After reviewing the events, we have decided to rule in favor of the concept of good. We will. As we have ruled in favor of good, the people of Excalibur will pursue those virtues from this day forward.
Well, for now, I'd like to put some distance between myself and Excalibur. Returning to Earth, catching up on what's happened since 2257? Sounds like a good place to start to me. I understand that an old friend of mine is on a similar journey now. I'll get in touch with Commander Stamets soon. I'd love to get his unique perspective on things. There's a lot waiting for me out there. Thank you for helping me get the chance to discover once again.
Congratulations, Captain.